Good morning, children. I hope all you are fine. Today we are going to conduct brief of grade 10, Sociology, Chapter 2, Labor. About this chapter, first video we already done. In that, I already told you what is the labor and what are the important division of work of a labor. Okay. Now we talk about in this video that which are the categories which pay and without pay labors are there. Okay. First is the labors without pay. It means those are the labors without pay. Okay. If the work is done without the payment of the anything, any cash or kind, it is called a labor without pay. And if this kind of work is called such a compensation, it means like NGO type of works or payless work, they are the people only doing work as like a hobbies or as like a self motivation or as just like improve their own status, their own hobbies, their own skills. If those work is known as a paid work without payment. Okay, you already heard about the NCC categories. The NCC categories, especially those are people, they are doing the work without payment only, okay, which is any welfare work, any other work, they are doing without payment. And in ITI or the nursing also, you saw that some work they are doing which is without payment. So those is also doing things. If we come according to under the family, that in our family also we are doing so many works. So in the family, our mother is doing without payment work every single day all the life. So she is also as known as a person who is a worker of a family but with unpaid. There is no salary for a mother work, for a housewife work. So those type of work which is considered without payment. Okay, those type of work which they are doing like a mother, any artist, or those work they are doing, it is their own satisfaction. It is their own skills. They want to give a more chance to their own self to just do a better work for them. That's why they are doing. Now, labor with the pay. With pay labors. Okay, labor with pay means according to this, they are getting money, they are getting salary for any work. It is known as the labor with pay. It is according to maybe the days, maybe the skill, maybe the hours, maybe the months. So some people, they are getting salary according to per week, according to per month, according to per day, or according to contract based, or all this kind of thing. It is known as a with pay labor. Okay, it's called a wages and is given according to different time period. It means in the all the business and the small role type of side businesses or the proper business or the employment, they are the people are just getting a payment for their work. It is also with according to hours, with according to time period, with according to shift also. If they are doing the extra work, that is mean they are giving the extra payment also. So it is all this kind of thing. Okay, in the most cases the people are in this kind of people expecting job, like all the type of professional work, like as a teacher, as a doctor, as any carpenter, as any wholesaler, as any shopkeeper, all this kind of works the people are just getting their money. Okay, now we talk about labors from organized sector and the unorganized. Okay, sector means those areas that they are doing the work, and organized and unorganized means some sectors which are the organized, it means there is a for them there is a proper qualification need, there is a proper criteria where their work and the proper perfect hours is there which they are working. Unorganized means there is a no time schedule, not a proper payment structure, or not a proper education that is required. These both are totally different, opposite from others. So first we talk about the organized sector. In organized sector, actually we know that our economy is divided into three sectors, which is a primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. In that, similarly, the based on the security and the facilities available, the labor sector further divided into organized and unorganized sector. So the sector which is enrolled as per the law of the government and provided the fixed wages, facilities within the framework of the law is called the anchorage sector. It means the sector is guided by the Minimum Wages Act, Factories Act, Employers Provident Fund Act, and many other acts to support of the laborers. Okay, so it means according to all these rules and regulation, those sector is working. They called organized sector, and the people are working in those sector. There is no other laborers from organized sector. In these sectors, the institution coming, which is maybe schools, hospitals, industries, government officers, government commercial banks, life insurance company, military and other services. So those are all come in the services where it is a fixed all the things according to government rules and regulation. There this kind of thing is coming. According to this, they are just getting their proper benefit, proper salary, proper work hour, and the other extra benefit which is already promised by the institution according to the rules and regulation. If you already maybe any organization promised that they are giving the prominent fund from their salary, so it is already just to cut it from the salary, deduct from the salary, and just directly add it in their PF account. And that account is a when the people want all to gather the money, it is just like a saving amount for them. So this kind of fund system, they are just providing by the organized sector only, not the unorganized sector. Especially those kind of organized sector, they are just specially do with the all kind of salary giving facility with the account system only. So it's a proper system with the proper management. Now next is the labors with the unorganized sector. It means in those type of sector, there is no legal provisions are there. There is not any legal guidelines are there, or there is not any registration system are there, and there is not a proper record for any employee. It's this type of sector are known as an unorganized sector. It means the local vendors, you saw that the vegetable sellers, fish on hand, selling of the vegetable sellers, vehicle repairs, all this kind of those people, they are known as an unorganized sector. It means they are working day also, night also. There is not a proper fixed hour. There is not a proper amount which they are getting. There is not a proper time period where is the holiday, where there is not a holiday. Nothing. Totally unorganized thing. So those sectors is known, those areas known unorganized sector, and the neighbors who are working is called laborers in unorganized sector. Okay, for those there is no leaves, no other benefits, no insurance, no PF fund, no act, no rules, no regulation, nothing is there. Okay, because they are not registered with any organization, and there is no rules and regulations are there. They are work according to their own capacity. If they have a capacity, they are just come and stand their work. If they don't have a capacity, they are not coming and not doing their work. So this is called unorganized sector. Okay, now we talk about the challenges faced by the unorganized sector workers. Organized sector, they are not facing so much challenges. Still challenges their job because there is a lot of competition in the present time according to education and the facilities or the all the institution. But for the unorganized sector, there are different things coming because there is no perfect rules and regulation for them. So if there is no rules and regulation, there are the things is the everyday changes. It means first we think about the migration. Okay, migration means one place to second place movement. Why? If a person is the start of vegetable shop in a one place, but he's not proper getting the proper customers, and he's not able to just get it proper, he will just close the shop and just go for the another place. Maybe that person coming from the any rural area, so he just go back from the rural area. So this kind of migration facilities, migration type of problems is just in the unorganized sector. It means circular migration is done. It means they are not able to do a proper work according to this migration things. Okay, so they are roaming in the search of a work from one place to another. Okay, you saw that the construction workers, yeah. So the mostly the this kind of migrant workers are the construction type of workers, because they don't have a proper. If any building their work within finish within a 6 months. So after 6 months, they have to again search a work for a new place. If they are getting job, they can do for other place. If they are not, they have to go for back to again their home, which is maybe far away, which is maybe in the native place, which is maybe in the other side, on the state also. So those are the major problem for the unorganized sector. Next is the social security. It means there is no proper housing facilities, food, water, drinking, equal opportunity, nothing is there. It means all the social security is not for them. Because first thing, there is not a proper amount which they are getting according to monthly basis, according to weekly basis. Because if they are working, amount is in their hand. If they are not working, amount is not. So the social security is not for them. So it is a totally a zero benefits for them. Next is a legal framework. In the legal framework, according to Minimum Age Act, Minimum Wages Act of 1971, they are not applicable for those unorganized sector. Because I told you before, there is not a rules and regulation which apply by the any those sectors. So if they are not applying, there is any not a rules apply according to it means they are not make sure that those are they are working in under of those people, they are just giving the proper and the fixed minimum wages. So it is a framework which is not good for them. Okay, next is the child labor. Okay, do you know that especially in the unorganized sector only we saw the many child labor, those who are working in the small restaurants and the hotels and the factories and the buildings areas and all this thing. Because those children, they are maybe the dropout from the school and their parents or maybe in any condition they just came from the home and were searching for a job, and because they are not proper educated, they are not proper according to age of the job. So it means this is the sector where they are getting the job. So it means the mostly child labor in this unorganized sector only we found. Especially the harmful industries are really are risky industries. Okay. Next is the physical and mental exploitation. Okay. Physical exploitation, it means if you are in an organized sector, your time is a fixed. Morning 9 to 5. After that, you no need to work. You no need to stay because there is not a rule for doing extra work for them. But if you are in a half-burnout sector, they are just not a proper schedule is there for them. If the work is a more, they can do for the 18 hours, 16 hours, 12 hours. If the work is less, they can do for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. So according to this physical expedition and the mental situation, which means if they are not getting proper job, there is maybe so many things is issues going on that time, the mental expedition is also there. So, according to 2014-15 statistics, there are 77% of the women works in an unorganized sector. Okay, that is a huge number because if the women are working in an organized sector, they are just in a proper timing doing their work and they are just be fit and proper. But if they are doing work because those are the labor's condition, with all of the sector, their time schedule is not fixed and their wage is not proper. So that's why the physical and mental exploitation is also there. So children, those are the differentiate between the organized and the unorganized sectors according to labor and the with pay and without pay labors. So now I'm going to bind my session. Thank you.